For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice in it, right?
Yes.
Amen.
I just want to thank the Lord for blessing me to be alive and well, and blessing us to make it here safely. Amen. Glory to his holy name. For he is so worthy to be praised.
Yes.
I'm going to start off with 100 number of Psalms. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endure in all generations. Praise the Lord for his word. I am now going to be reading from 150 number of Psalms. Please bear with me. Thank you, Jesus. Praise ye the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God in his sanctuary.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him in the firmament of his power.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him for his mighty acts.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him according to his excellence and greatness.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him with the sound of the trumpet.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him with the psaltery and harp.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him with the tremble and dance.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him with the stringing instruments.
Praise the Lord.
And organs.
Yes.
Praise him upon the loud cymbals.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals.
Praise the Lord.
And everything that has breath.
Praise the Lord.
Praise ye the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The word of God.
Oh,
Praise God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And then we have our young champions.
Yes, young champions. Come on, young champions. Praise the Lord. Come on, young champions. Come on, champions. Praise God. Don't be shy up there now. Come on. Give God the glory. Give God the glory, champs. Jesus, we got the praise. Jesus, we got the praise. Jesus, 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 Jesus,
Jesus. Keep up the praise.
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 Don't stop the praise.
Don't stop the praise.
Don't stop the praise.
Don't stop the praise.
Bring on the praise.
Bring on the praise.
Bring on the praise.
Jesus.
Glory to God.
Bring on the praise. Don't stop the praise.
Don't stop the praise.
Bring on the praise.
Jesus,
Jesus.
Jesus,
Jesus.
Jesus,
Jesus.
Jesus,
Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus,
Jesus, yo champs, young champs, glory to God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Bless y'all. Bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. My ministry, praise the Lord.
Destroy you, he does it with grace. Anybody bring grace when he broke him?
Yes. you, Jesus.
Thank you for walking before you. Thank you for handling us with grace. Just lift your worship right there in this moment.
Thank you.
you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Glory to God. Praise God. Gracefully broken. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God.
Testing, one, two, three, four. Hallelujah. Give all the hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Give all the hands. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
We thank the Lord for the young settlers. Oh yeah, the young chance. Amen. We got a community coming up. Amen. Hallelujah. And thank you even for the praise and worship. Hallelujah. And my lovely wife for 17 years. Amen. Just started out, amen. The word of God is always good and stuff. She said, praise the Lord.
Amen.
You said what?
Praise the Lord.
Praise God in the sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent and greatness.
Amen.
And at the end of it, said, let everything have breath.
Everything. Praise the Lord.
Let everything have breath. Amen. God is good all the time. God is good. Amen. We're getting to a lesson. Amen. And we just thank you for God for blessing us with the second Sunday of this year.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Second Sunday of this year. Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
God bless us. Amen. He blessed us to have legs and mind and everything to breathe and eat and talk with others. He blesses, hallelujah, so many funerals, one church is one, two funerals. So he's in, I see a long line, amen. You can bury us right when you see that the graveyards are filling up now. God is calling people home.
Yes.
So if you know somebody, tell them about Jesus.
Yes.
Say, brother, sister, I know you pray. We like, oh, I don't want to offend them. I don't want to chase them away. But you do not want them in a fire. When you see somebody in a burning house fire, you go in there, run in there, and get them out. You want to get them out of there. The firefighter got to get them out of there. You see somebody on their way to a burning fire, say something. You see them, say something. Talk to them. You can save them. Jesus is the reason. Amen. Jesus is everything. You got to tell them, bro, sis, you got to get right with Christ. You got to. Because I don't want you to go to a bad place. Christ loves you. Talk to him. He died for the whole world. When he died for the whole world, he put the whole world on his shoulders. And you got to find a way how to talk to him. Talk to him in a way you're going to minister to him. If they're into weightlifting, they say, when Christ carried the whole world on his back, that got to heaven. From the future, past, and present, that got to heaven. And then we'll just look at you like, you speak my language now. As way as it, amen. Hallelujah. Let's say a prayer. Father, touch this message. In the name of the Lord Jesus. And I thank you. Thank you for allow me to learn more about it, Lord. Touch us all here today. We're here to get something out of this service today. We need to come here empty-handed, Lord. And we know that you will open up the door and pour us out a blessing. You said not enough room to receive it. That you will fill this room with the Holy Ghost. Lord, we just thank you, Lord Jesus, that we're here, Lord Jesus. Open arms, Lord Jesus, ready to receive, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for your grace, multiplied grace. Lord, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We open our hearts unto you, Lord. Nobody perfect, Lord Jesus. We all make mistakes. We thank you that you show mercy to us, Lord Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. The title of this lesson is A Taste of the Lord.
A Taste of the Lord. Praise God.
Taste of the Lord.
Amen. Just a taste
of the Lord. Psalm 34:8, King James Version. You got a Bible app? Look it up. I encourage you to continue on. Find more learning tools. King James Version. I like the Bible Study Bible. Amen. It's got a lot of meat in it. If you can break down the scriptures from all the way to the top to the bottom. If you want to learn some more about the scriptures, I encourage you to. That's the best investment that you can ever have. That investment is better than any car, house, anything.
Amen.
Best investment is in the Word of God. Amen.
Amen.
You learn it. Amen. The one that knows your future, the one that knows your past, the one that knows everything, he knows the outcome of what's going to happen with you. He knows the last day that you're going to be on earth. He knows the last seconds, the last breath. I'll say we gotta get connected with Jesus because he knows every single thing. Stay connected. He knows everything. He knows us better than we know ourselves. He knows what you need, he knows what you want. Psalms 34:8. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusted in him. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusts in him. To taste involves testing or sampling. To see involves understanding or receiving. The phrase taste and see then means try and experience. David urges God's people to discover the goodness of the Lord by personal trial and experience it for themselves. He is telling you, I tasted the Lord, and I want you to taste it for yourself. Don't just take my word for it. I'm going to tell you right now. Taste it, and he wants some experience.
Yes.
Woo! God's people to discover the goodness of the Lord by personal trial and experience it for themselves. When we go through our trials, that taste of that Lord will help you overcome. That's what he's trying to tell you. He doesn't want readers to merely take his word for it, that the Lord is good. He wants them to actively experience it and know themselves that the fact that God is good. And say all the time, say, what you got to say?
God is good.
Amen. You ever went to the store extremely hungry? That's rule number one. Do not go to the store extremely hungry. You will not come out with money. Your hands, you grab it. You know what my trick is? I tried to do it without shopping. I tried to touch a shopping cart. I push the shopping cart over, but I don't want to pull the shopping cart up. So, but I still end up walking around with a bunch of stuff. And still try to check all those things. Shopping cart. I walk all over there myself and take the shopping cart. And then I'm like, oh, you won't win this time, but next time you're going to win next time. You go to the store hungry, you buy it yourself. Extremely stuff, my stuff. You know, you start to pick up the stuff that you need. You need this, I need this, I need that. Am I right? That's one of the rules that says, that's one story of hunger because you purchase everything.
Yes.
You want to buy some of this, lasagna, spaghetti, all the kind of things. And then, you remember they used to taste test later. Right at the door or something like that, she got cookies on the little thing that makes the stomach hungry, man. She has a chocolate chip or something on a little tissue, whatever. And she said, man, then you don't drink much. You don't drink away, you drink away, and she's looking at you, okay, now you have a box. She started using. So when you taste it, then you want to buy what she offered. And that's her job, because when you taste it, and all of a sudden, whatever she offered, she went through the sell to you. This is what David is talking about. David extends the invitation to taste and see that the Lord is good. And he invites us to perform a taste test about something he has discovered. Some people, when they discover something, they find something, they try to hold, you know, scientists, they try to take claims on it, write a signature on it, opponents. But David is telling them, when I discovered this, and it was beautiful, he said, I'm willing to share with you that you need to try it yourself. We know what David was doing. David was a lot of trials and tribulations. Amen. He fought against Goliath, and he thought the battle was over. He fought against Goliath, and he thought the battle was over. And then he went up, and then he had a situation with Beersheba, and he thought that was over. Then he had a situation with his sons, and he thought that was over. So David knows what it takes to get back with the Lord and what is required. He knows. Amen. I'm going to say that, again, Jesus is our hope. He knows what you need and knows what you want. And some people, they can't stand to hear bad news in their life. They can't stand to hear this. But David was encouraging them, when you taste the Lord, that you will not be fazed by the bad news that you hear. That you always will know that there is a hope at the end of the tunnel. There's a finish line at the end of the tunnel. Jesus is our good news. Amen. He died on the cross for our sins. It was rose. So when you hear the bad news, don't you know that there's good news to surpass that bad news? There's good news to surpass that bad news. Jesus will give us hope. So now he's letting you know that that storm is not going to last forever. Wherever you're going through in your life, that the storm is not going to last forever. That situation is not going to last forever. That whatever, when you taste a piece of the Lord, hallelujah, when you taste a piece of the Lord, that good news, amen, it will surpass any bad news in your life. John 15:18. Some people jump into 18, but we live today. Some people think, well, why is bad things happening? My God came to me and asked me this. He said, I'm tired of looking at the news. So much bad things are happening. He said, why is God allowing so much bad things to happen? And I told him, I said, well, this goes back to Adam and Eve in the garden. Adam and Eve sinned in the garden. We gave keys to Satan, he became the prince of this world. So, and Jesus is saying right here, if the world hated you, you know that it hated me before. It hated me before. John 15:18. If the world hates you, you know that it hated me before. So, in other words, is that you're going to go through the same. You're going to go through some things. You are on the territory of the enemy. You ain't in his territory. Of course you're going to have some nicks and bruises. Of course you're going to face a lot of trials and tribulations. He's letting you know that. I went through it. You're going to go through it. David urges you to come out of your comfort zone. There's a beautiful flavor out there, and all he wants you to do is just taste. Tell your neighbor, just taste.
Just taste.
Just taste.
Amen.
Matthew 5:6 says, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. John 4:13 says, Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water should never thirst again. John 6:35 said, and Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. Amen. I am the bread of life. He used a great example of saying bread. Because that's the last thing you want to eat when you're at the dinner table. Why do I want to eat the bread first?
Because it fills you up.
Yeah. It fills you up, and then you got all this food ahead.
Mm-hmm.
So some people wait for the little wait. And if they have the buffet, oh man, I know you all that bread. Some macaroni over there. It's some macaroni, some potatoes, some cheese, all that stuff over there. I don't need all that. And then see, that's why you use a good prime example of bread. Bread filling. And Jesus knows that that's a prime example of you because he knows it's going to fill you up. He said, and he said unto them, I am the bread of life. I am the bread of life. Jesus said, He that come to me should never hunger. He that believe on me should never thirst.
never thirst. The Lord is like a parent. And when you come to him, you know, when you come up alongside and you starving, the Lord can't stand to look at his children starving. He can't. He can't stand to see his children starving. The Lord will pull a chair right and put you to sit at the table of his presence. He will fill your cup until it overflows. Only to ask, because he will not force you to eat, but he will put it right there in your reaching distance. Amen. The Lord has a buffet of love for you. He has so much to offer you. It's like a magnet pulling. Amen. When you taste, you have a magnetic pull in you. Amen. The Lord will want to force you to eat. That will not be love. Amen. I brought an example right here on the table here. But all the Lord is asking for you is come. Just taste. When you taste some of that love, you will want the plate. The word of God will fulfill.
Amen.
The word of God will fulfill. And I said the word of God will fulfill it.
Yes.
The word of God will fulfill it.
Yes.
In taste, you will want more. You will want more. That's what David is telling you right now. He said, all I want you to do, just come over and just taste it. Look at the Lord's number said. Here. Eat over there. The Lord wants you to grab it. He's not going to put it in your hand. He wants you to grab it, but that will not be love. If he had to force you to just taste something so powerful, he uses something so small because we act like it's so much to do. We act like it's so much. That's why he used the grain of a mustard seed. He said, if you have a faith of a grain of a mustard seed, some people think you gotta do so much. But he said, come and taste. But once you taste, your stomach is going to want more. Come on over here. I got some more for you. The Lord got more for you. He got more for you. He never left you. He always with you. Yes, hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, just taste.
Just taste.
Pour your glass of living water. The Lord is always pouring blessings upon us. Amen. Malachi 3:10 said, bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there will maybe be meat in my house. Tell your neighbor, just taste.
Just taste.
And prove me now, how good, said the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, then will not be enough room to receive it. Say, just taste.
Just taste.
Amen. What does it mean? What does it mean to just taste, to see that the Lord is good? Amen. Tasting must happen before seeing. That is our spiritual experience bringing us to spiritual alignment and understanding. When you taste, all your problems will come together. Why things are happening. The news will start to make sense. Because the prophecy said that was going to happen. So you're like, oh, that's prophecy. Everything is happening right now. Prophecy. So when you taste from the Lord, you have nothing to worry about. Because you know that the prophecy already said that this is going to happen, so it's already got you, it's already ahead, it's already telling you what's about to happen. It's preparing you for what's about to happen. So when you taste from the Lord, he'll give you that comfort and let you know that there's light at the end of the tunnel, that the storm will not last all the way, it should clear up. You already know because there's hope. And the hope is in Jesus. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
Psalms 34 goes on to outline the example of God's incredible goodness to those who take refuge in his, and in him. He takes care of every one of our needs. Hallelujah. Provides for them for good, long life. He is with them through troubles with us in troubles and saves us from our enemies. Hallelujah. Just taste. Believers in Jesus experience taste of God's goodness and grace, and we observe the beauty of his creation or recognize his blessings of provision and protection and care. We taste and see his goodness when we contemplate on his holiness
Hallelujah. So what does this tell you? That everything that the Lord is telling us right now, all you have to do is come and he will reveal to you what's going on in your life. He will reveal to you what's going on right now. Why the storm is happening and there's a way out of it. But all he's waiting for you to do, just taste. Shake your neighbor and say, taste!
Taste!
Amen. Hallelujah. He's not going to force you to take it. He wants you to reach up and grab it. He said, reach up!
Reach up!
And grab it.
And grab it.
The Lord is good. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. It's, I'm talking about the Lord is good. The Bible tells us the word good actually means holy, pure, righteous. The goodness describes as a fruit of the Spirit is not merely moral behavior, but an excellent of his character. The goodness is only through God's grace and mercy. We often say in church, God is good, and you say what? All the time?
God is good.
And he saw when he did creation, and he saw that it was good. And in the beginning, God created, and he said it was good. The first day, the light was created, he said it was good. The second day, the sky was created, and he said it was good. The third day, the dry land, the sea, the plants, and the trees were created, and he said it was what?
Good.
He said it was good. The fourth day, the sun, moon, and stars were created, and he said what?
Good.
It was good. By the seventh day, he rested. He rested in his work on his work, making it the seventh day a special holy day. God wants us to understand that all we have to do is just reach for it. And just taste. Once you taste some of the Lord, it will fulfill you. See, sometimes the enemy will try to distract us. We're in his territory, so of course he's going to try to have other sources trying to fill the void, but you can't fill the void of someone that got unlimited space, got unlimited powers. You can't fill that void. The world cannot give to you what God can give to you. You'll eventually get hungry again, you know. When we kids, we eat the plant hops over and over. We was hungry again. Well, Dad had a pot of beans in the back. Dad had a pot of beans on the stove. When we came for our long ride to go pick up the flaming hot chips, we went all the way down there and came back the same way we left. We went hungry and came back home because we don't have all the calories riding back 30 miles. But thank God that Dad had a pot of beans.
Amen.
He knows that it's going to sit on you and weigh on you.
Yes.
He knows it's going to hit you hard.
Yes.
That pot of beans. Hard, and he pulls the cornbread right out of the oven, and he knows that the cornbread is going to hit you hard.
Yes.
And God knows what's going to fill you up.
Yes.
He knows what's going to hit you hard.
Yes.
He knows what's going to fill you up, and he's going to give you some hot heels. He's going to try to give you some little small little jump rules, little tip rolls, but God's going to give you something like a pot of beans and some cornbread.
Amen.
He's going to know that you're going to sit back and pick your teeth. Because he knows that you're going to be hungry and satisfied.
Amen.
So he thanked the Lord that he knows when he knows before. Hallelujah. Turn to the neighbor. Just taste and see.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Let's go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, my goodness. Father, thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you are the word that you pray. Hallelujah.
We thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you for this message. Let us all taste and see. Let us all taste, Lord. Hallelujah. You're awesome, Lord. You're worthy to be praised, Lord Jesus.
Yes, God.
We cannot do this without you, Lord Jesus.
Yes, God.
You're the Alpha and the Omega, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
We're here with our arms wide open. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated. Amen.
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 One from another.
This we ask
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
If every soul,
save a soul,
then
every soul shall be saved.
Tell your neighbors, I love you.
I love you.